The proposal was contained in a presentation by the Finance Committee leadership as it appeared to present the budget framework for Minister of Finance. The current annual national budget requirement for maintenance of roads is approximately 1.4 trillion shillings, but government has only provided 487 billion for the financial year 2023-2024, leaving a funding gap of 900 billion shillings. Legislators are concerned that the road sector budget has been skewed, causing a backlog in road maintenance and construction. Currently under the road fund, the districts receive approximately 150 million shillings for road maintenance per year, which is insufficient.
The funding gap, whatever, I think it should not be there now. We are tired of that. Let's use whatever little money to honor the priority areas. As we talk now, remember during the COVID, what happened? Didn't we sacrifice a number of activities and we moved on? Let's look for priority areas. To me, the priority areas is, for example, power, roads, and health. Education, you have messed it up.
In this regard, the Finance Committee is proposing new levy of about 200 per litre of diesel and petrol with effect from the financial year 2023-2024 to finance activation of the Uganda Road Fund to make it fully operational.
But we are proposing that at least 200 shillings on a litre of fuel be added, and whatever is raised from that 200 shillings per litre of fuel should go towards the road fund to maintain the roads.
If this proposal succeeds, the fuel levy will be in addition to the current excise duty charged on fuel of about 1,450 and 1,130 shillings per litre.
To each litre, and you should study the motorists that we are adding 200 shillings so that your vehicle can pass on a motorable road. They will pay the money. But the issue is, like somebody put it, the government will be looking at that soft spot where money is easily comes. And I would want to know, how many liters of fuel do we sell in the country? Katashumba, can you help us? How many liters do we sell? Million? 6 million liters. Okay, when you multiply by 200 shillings, you know what it means. It's not 400 billion. It's over a trillion.
The Budget Committee of Parliament is also against the idea of rationalizing the Uganda Road Fund and the National Roads Authority in the ongoing rationalization policy, arguing that it will affect service delivery.
But before you even print the money, first of all, is to have a position whether it should be rationalized. Because that's the beginning part. If you are going to rationalize it and put it in the other ministry, then your whole debate will get defeated. So the beginning part is whether you have members of parliament convinced that some agencies should not be rationalized. And one of them is Road Fund, and in my humble view, another one is UNRWA.
On the same budget, Roko Construction Company is expected to get a share of 2 bills of exchange that will be due in the financial year. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.